What's up, Internet? Kevin here on Tech of Tomorrow. Now, for those of you that are unaware, one of the biggest things to come out today was the Battlefield 4 beta. Now, right now, it is an exclusive beta only available to people that purchased either Battlefield 3 Premium or Medal of Honor Warfighter, or if you didn't buy either of those, you can also get in by pre-ordering the Digital Deluxe Edition of the game. Now, those of you that just aren't willing to do any of those yet, it will go into full open beta for everyone starting on the 4th, running through the 15th. So I grabbed it this morning and jumped on to play a couple of games, tried out some of the new features, and ran a couple of benchmarks, so let's go ahead and take a quick look at one of the most anticipated games of 2013. So in the beta, you play on the Shanghai map, and you can play it in either Domination or Conquest mode, which are basically the same game mode in concept. It's just that Domination is a small-scale one with 3 points and smaller teams, whereas Conquest is the full-scale map with 64 players at once. Now, the main focus of this beta is to really show off this particular map, and how it's meant to encapture the style of Battlefield 4. There's a good mix of needing land, air, and sea vehicles, all of which are useful, and the level prominently features what DICE has been calling levolution, the idea that maps change as the battle progresses. While there's lots of little examples of this throughout the map, the big key one that really shows it off is the skyscraper in the middle of the stage, that if you shoot the supports for it, brings the whole thing crashing down, totally changing the landscape of the area, as well as the tactics needed to capture it. Now, that aside, the core dynamic is still very much the same as Battlefield 3, albeit the gameplay is even prettier, and numerous little tweaks have been made. So while running the game on our system, which has an MSI GTX 780, as well as an i7 4770K processor overclocked to 4 GHz, we tested the beta on medium, high, and ultra settings, which we benchmarked at 88, 81, and 73 frames per second, respectively. Now, of course, this is based on the beta of the game, which is not properly indicative of what the full title will be like once it's released. A lot of this content has not been properly optimized, and there's plenty of odd little bugs and glitches. So, of course, we will run these tests again once the actual game is released. Now, for those same reasons, I don't want to go too in-depth on the gameplay because, as I said, it's a beta, which means you're never quite sure what balances and such are going to make it to launch. But what I will talk about is just my experience so far that has been pretty damn awesome. While I am more of a fan of the Rush mode, which BF3 used in its beta, Conquest does create a fun sort of shove back and forth match, especially with the focus on levolution. At the start of matches, you'll see a lot of people relying on helicopter drops and big in-air battles to try and gain supremacy over the central tower, and it's easy to hold at first since it's so high up and you can hold off enemy assaults pretty easy. But then it gets really crazy if you don't have people protecting the base, and the whole thing collapses and levels the area, turning it into an uneven terrain. One new neat little feature that I noticed that I really liked too is that when you choose where to redeploy, when selecting teammates, you actually get a little camera view of what's going on directly around them, giving you a better idea of what kind of situation you're getting yourself into so you can act right away after spawning. So this is just a quick little recap of what we've gotten to see so far in the beta. Those of you that can't wait to try it out for yourselves, as I said earlier, you can get in on the action today by pre-ordering the Digital Deluxe Edition of the game, if you don't already qualify. Or you can wait until October 4th for it to go full open beta and get a taste of what the game will be like when it finally launches on the 25th of this month. And for those of you that have already been playing the beta, please make sure to let us know in the comments what you think so far based on your experiences. What changes do you like, not like, what things do you hope they fix, or just your thoughts and feelings on the Shanghai map itself and what it might mean for the game in its whole when it's finally released. Now while you're commenting down there, please go ahead and make sure to smash that like button to let us know how much you've been enjoying this content, as well as subscribe if you haven't yet so you can stay up to date in all of our future reviews and unboxings, including when we take a look at Battlefield 4 when it gets released at the end of this month. Till then, you guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. I'm Kevin, and thank you so much for watching.